getting there when fire racers set signal cabling ablaze near London Bridge.
This morning's arson attack brought one of the busiest rail junctions in Europe to a standstill and caused tens of thousands of passengers to be trapped in trains, some for more than 3 hours.
It's taken me 2 hours and 25 minutes to get here from Charlton, a 25 minutes journey. It's blasted, it's disgusting.
They're telling people to go to one station, then they're telling them to go somewhere else. We've had this for 3 hours.
Disgusting it is. Really disgusting. They should do something about it, and now I'm trying to write to them and want my money back.
The fire was in a trackside location box which controls signals and points and destroyed one of the most crucial pieces of equipment on Network South East. Services will be severely disrupted until Thursday at least, and tomorrow's outlook is also bleak.
We are not going to be able to put the full service back before Thursday of this week.
So what will that mean for commuters tomorrow morning?
It's going to mean that trains are going to be overcrowded and that their journey, they should allow more time for their journey and expect to be put into a terminal station that they may not normally use.
Three South Londoners who tried to pull off a £1 million armed raid on a security van in Surrey have been jailed for a total of 58 years. Police regard them as the modern-day equivalent of the notorious Cray Gang.
After weeks of planning and plotting, the armed gang swooped on this security van at Woodhatch in November last year. The van contained just over £800,000. When two of the security guards got out to buy teas, the robbers sped towards them in a stolen red truck. As the guards were bundled back into their van, police swooped. 30 detectives and a firearms squad burst from cover. One of the gang, Kenneth Baker, raised a loaded pistol. Fearing he was about to open fire, police shot him dead. He was wearing this Ronald Reagan mask. Sentencing the three men, Her Honour Judge Heather Steele described them as dangerous, ruthless, greedy and clever men from whom society must be protected for a very long time. She jailed Dennis Arif for 22 years and his brother Mehmet for 18. Mehmet's brother-in-law, Anthony Downer, was also sentenced to 18 years.
By any standards, this was a first division team of robbers. They went out that day determined that they weren't going to be caught. Each of the gang was carrying a fully loaded handgun, but in addition, in the flatback truck that they had, there was a fully loaded pump-action shotgun.
Detectives have reopened their investigation into the murder of a Surrey schoolboy found strangled 23 years ago. Jonathan Ray has this report.
In April 1968, Roy Tuttle was found dead near Mickleham in Surrey. He'd been sexually assaulted and strangled. The case provoked outrage. A motorist was known to have given Roy a lift home from Kingston Grammar School, but a nationwide search came up with nothing, and for more than two decades, the case has remained unsolved. 14-year-old Roy's body was found in this woodland. There's a busy road nearby. Now Surrey police have received new information about the mystery driver. It could bring detectives closer to finding whoever killed this Surrey schoolboy 23 years ago.
Scotland Yard has named a man they're seeking after explosives were discovered in an East London garage. The anti-terrorist squad wants to interview 21-year-old Damien Stanley from Newry in Northern Ireland, who's believed to be a student. The explosives were found at a lock-up garage in Wanstead 10 days ago after an off-duty police officer challenged a man who was acting suspiciously. The man fled, leaving behind a bag containing weapons. A 12-year-old girl from Dartford has won £800,000 agreed High Court damages for a medical blunder which has left her facing the rest of her life with the mind of a baby. Stephanie Clay was 21 months old when she went into Dartford's Joyce Green Hospital with bronchial pneumonia. She came out of the hospital with severe brain damage as well as physical handicaps. The world's most expensive collection of cameras has been sold at a West End auction. The sale at Christie's featured a huge array of spy cameras. Disguises for the tools of the espionage trade included fake watches, old and new, and even a packet of cigarettes, complete with a box of matches, concealing a light meter. The collection fetched £300,000, a record for a camera sale. Musical star Sarah Brightman is making a West End comeback in one of her former husband's musicals. She's taking over the lead role in Andrew Lloyd Webber's Aspects of Love after starring in the show on Broadway.
5 years ago, Sarah Brightman was the star of Andrew Lloyd Webber's The Phantom of the Opera, and she was his wife.
The Phantom of the Opera is now.
Sarah and Andrew divorced a year ago, but she's happy to be back in one of his shows.
Well, to tell you the truth, I haven't really worked with him on the show, and I didn't do it when I first did it on Broadway. You know, I worked with the director, Trevor Nunn, and obviously all the people to do with the music. But it's great. I'm an artist, and if a Lloyd Webber show comes up and I'm right for the role, well, it's great if I can do it.
And he must be thrilled. It must have given his show a big boost.
Well, you'll have to ask him.
Sarah Brightman's 8-week run in Aspects of Love at the Prince of Wales Theatre begins tomorrow night.
And the Thames weather, dry, clear and bitterly cold overnight, with the temperature down to -5 Celsius, that's 23 degrees Fahrenheit. There'll be widespread frost and fog patches. Tomorrow, dry with a good deal of sunshine, but staying cold, the top temperature around 4 Celsius, 39 Fahrenheit. And that's the Thames news on Monday, December the 9th. Good night.
Make time for Thames this Tuesday, when at 8, a domestic disturbance calls for smart action from the Bill. At 8.30, the upper hand.
Your eyes shine, Laura, as if heaven itself resides in them.
I'd like to bear your children.
Bones of 9, is Harry being set up?
He'll be safe enough until tomorrow.
You better be right, Rowley.
Harry Crawford, you take the biscuit.
And with the snooker at 10.40, you'll be queuing up to watch tomorrow on Thames.
Next tonight, we continue Wall Street.
Clint Eastwood is a stranger in town.
I don't think it's nice, you laughing.
A Fistful of Dollars next Monday at 10.40.
As a result of attending the scene of a road accident, I spoke with the driver and suspected that this man had been drinking.
You've heard what the officer has said. Do you understand?
Empty your pockets. Now turn them inside out.
In here. You have agreed to provide a specimen of blood for laboratory analysis.
Sit down and roll up your left sleeve, please.
I regret to inform you that the girl is dead.
You do not have to say anything unless you wish to do so. But what you say may be given in evidence. Cup of tea, sir.
St. Ivel Gold is a low-fat spread for people who like a fresh, dairy taste. So if you're aiming for low-fat with a delicious taste, St. Ivel Gold will bowl you over.
Join us tonight at the Dome Leisure Centre in Doncaster to see snooker's hottest property in action, world champion John Parrott. Parrott's up against the world number 5, Gary Wilkinson, in the quarter-final of the World Match Play Tournament. It's the best of 17 frames, and you can see the match later tonight on ITV.
Now, the concluding part of Wall Street.